our enemy. Our, mine and his and both. He's my father.
But what proof do you have, Mr. Harris?
I told you. The hog got into my corn. I caught it up and sent it back to him. He had no fence that would hold it. I told him so, warned him. When he came to get it, I gave him enough wire to patch up his pen. I rode down to his house and saw the wire I gave him still rolled onto the spool in his yard. I told him he could have the hog when he paid me a dollar. That evening, a man came with a dollar and got the hog. He was a strange man. He said, "He said to tell you wood and hay can burn." I said, "What?" That night my barn burned. I got the stock out, but I lost the barn.
Where's the man? Have you got him?
He was a strange man, I tell you. I don't know what became of him.
But that's not proof. Don't you see that's not proof?
Get that boy up here. He knows. Not him. The little boy. The boy.
He aims for me to lie, and I will have to do it.
What's your name, boy?
Colonel Cyrus Snopes.
Hey, talk louder. Colonel Cyrus? I reckon anybody named for Colonel Cyrus in this country can't help but tell the truth, can they?
Enemy! Enemy!
Do you want me to question this boy?
No! Send him out of here!
This case is closed. I can't find against you, Snopes, but I can give you advice. Leave this country and don't come back to it.
Foots, white man, before you come in here. Mage ain't home no how.
Get out of my way, Negro.
Miss Lula, I tried. I told him to.
Will you please go away? Major D. Spain is not at home. Will you please go away?
Realize you have ruined that rug. It costs $100, but you never had $100. You never will. So I'm going to charge you 20 bushels of corn against your crop. That won't keep Mrs. Despain quiet, but maybe will teach you to wipe your feet off before you enter her house again.
Pap, you done the best you could. If he wanted it done different, why didn't he wait until he had? He won't get no 20 bushels. He won't get none. We'll gather it and hide it. I can walk.
Did you put the cutter back in that straight stock like I told you?
No, sir.
Then go do it.
He ain't done it. He ain't burnt.
Go back to the wagon.
Burnt? Do I understand this rug was burned too?
Does anybody here claim it was? Go back to the wagon.
And you claim 20 bushels of corn is too high for the damage you did to the rug?
He brought the rug to me and said he wanted the tracks washed out of it. I washed the tracks out and took the rug back to him.
But you didn't carry the rug back to him in the same condition it was in before you made the tracks on it. Young declined to answer that, Mr. Snopes. I'm going to find against you, Mr. Snopes. I'm going to find that you were responsible for the injury to Major Despain's rug and hold you liable for it. But 20 bushels of corn seems too high for a man in your circumstances to have to pay. Major Despain claims it costs $100. October corn will be worth about 50 cents. I figure that if Major Despain can stand a $95 loss on something he paid cash for, you can stand a $5 loss you haven't earned yet. I'll hold you in damages to Major Despain to the amount of 10 bushels of corn over and above your contract with him, to be paid to him out of your crop at gathering time. Court adjourned.
Go Go to the barn and get that can of oil we were oiling the wagon with.
What are you?
Go get that oil. Go.
I could keep on. I could run on and on. And never look back. Never need to see his face again. Only, I can't. I can't. To Spain! Where's? Barn! Barn!
What? Barn?
Yes, barn! Ha! Ha!